Oakland Craig and Norfolk Catholic. And Bridgeport's loss is to another playoff-bound team, North Platte St. Pat's. Both teams are averaging around 29 points per game offensively, but the big thing that leaps out in looking at the defensive averages is while Cedar Catholic has a good defense, giving up 18.5 points per game, with the big number, the 52 points Oakland Craig scored, which increased the average by nearly a touchdown a game on their defense. But Bridgeport has pitched 5 shutouts in their 7 games, and they gave up only 7 in the season opener against Sydney, with the most allowed 17 in their 3-point loss to North Platte St. Pat's for an average of 4 points allowed per game. But Cedar Catholic has weapons on offense, led by quarterback Tate Taney, who has passed for nearly 1,000 yards and thrown for half a dozen TDs. Running back Easton Becker has 1,194 yards rushing and 15 touchdowns. Bridgeport running back Cole Fessler has nearly the identical yardage at 1,157 and also 15 touchdowns. Bulldog quarterback Braden Stoll has completed 57% of his passes in accumulating 837 yards. Lots of players are related on the Cedar Catholic team. There are 4 players with the surname Aarons, 4 more with the name Taney, 3 with the name Hookstein, and a pair named Schroeders. We'll have to go with some first name identifications, obviously. Bridgeport is the home team by virtue of their 6th seed, while Cedar Catholic is the 11th seed. At halftime, I'll take a look at the C2 playoff bracket, but coming up next will be Chris Cottrell's visit with Bridgeport coach Jeremy Reiners. You're listening to the High Plains Spas and Recreation pregame show. For Hot Springs Spas and Green Mountain Grills, as well as RV, boat service, and accessories, it's High Plains Spas and Recreation. They sell fun.
Buying is filled with decisions. Neighborhood, floor plan, fenced yard. Make one choice that's easy. Start with FNBO first. We'll guide you home. Home buying is filled with decisions. Square feet, fixer upper, room to grow. Make one choice that's easy. Start with FNBO first. We'll guide you home.
At Elite Physical Therapy, we provide preventative and rehabilitative treatments that maximize function and promote well-being for patients of all ages. With 2 locations in Scottsbluff and Gearing, we offer the convenience of you choosing your location with the same great services no matter where you go. Stop into one of our locations today, in Scottsbluff at 214 West 27th Street or in Gearing at 10th and M Street, and see what Elite Physical Therapy can do for you. Treatment you need and care you deserve.
We're back on our High Plains Spas and Rec pregame show. Coverage today for playoff football on KDB.TV and radio on 93.3 KMOR. C2 first round action with Bridgeport at home to take on Hartington Cedar Catholic. Let's catch up right now with Bridgeport head football coach Jeremy Reimers. Coach, appreciate the time. Looking forward to catching up here, getting a little information on the Bulldogs and this big playoff matchup. So obviously this has been a topsy-turvy year, not just for everybody in general across the country, but really your football team has really gone through the highs and the lows of lows. Great season on the field and tragedy off. Let's start with Josh Warren. And how has the team handled the adversity of losing a teammate in season and still being able to play football, get into the classroom, and just go about their lives and try to do it the best they can?
Yeah, I mean, that was a tough deal, and it's still tough. Kids are working through it, but one thing I think it did, the seniors got a good, and we got a good culture going here at Bridgeport Football, and I really feel like it brought the kids closer together. Just as a whole unit, you can tell they're really just a lot closer, all that kind of stuff with it, and it was a tragedy, and kids are still finding ways to work through that, but I mean, they handled it the best they could, and kudos to them. And, I mean, I don't wish this on anyone. So,
is it a thing, and I'm sure each kid's different, but is it a thing where maybe some talk about it as an inspiration? Do some keep it inside? Is it more of a mental motivation? How's everybody keeping his spirit alive and trying to somehow, some way, turn it into a positive for them?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is motivation, because he was one of the top players for us over the last 3 years that he started, and he was just a fearless type of kid. And so a lot of our kids have tried to take that type of attitude and continue it on, try and play for him the style that he would like to be played. So I definitely think it's been a big motivator for some kids.
There's no playbook for this as a head coach. How have you and your staff gone about trying to be there for your kids?
Well, I mean, biggest thing is just be there. So first thing we did when we found out, we got the kids together right away that morning. That was a rough day. Got them all in the school. I didn't want anyone by themselves. And we just kind of found a way to work through it. Tough for everyone involved. But found a way to get through it, get to that game on that Friday. And that game, that first game against Gordon Rushville, and then the funeral the day after, that really helped some kids get. Now, you're never going to get total closure, but it really helped us find some closure in that aspect. But that game against Gordon Rushville was definitely a tough game to go through.
3-0 since the tragedy, and the defense has carried that spirit. You guys haven't allowed a point since then. So 28-0 against Gordon Rushville, 20-0 against Valentine, and a 37-0 shutout of Hershey. How big is a home playoff game for the community with everything going on?
I think it's really big, mainly because we also lost that game to Chase County at home, and so we've actually only had 3 home games this year. And so getting home playoff game, it's a tight-knit community here and a lot of community support through the whole deal. And so I think it's really awesome for the fans and everyone involved and Josh's mom, too, that we get a home playoff game.
This has to say a ton about your football team that you're able to, you know, battle through this type of thing, get to the playoffs, and be in a position to make some noise right now. I know you mentioned a lot of great senior leadership early in the season when we talked, and I would imagine that type of leadership is what it takes to get through this type of thing as a unit.
Yeah, they're a great bunch of kids. I could name off about every single one of them, and they all do something leadership-wise for the team that help us do something. Our captains would be like Cole Fessler, Cade Loomis, and Brady Newkirk. They do an awesome job for us, and they really set the standard high. And then some of those other seniors do some other great things for us, just leadership, knowing how we're supposed to practice, do the little things right, listen, hustle, all that kind of stuff that is unseen. But they really set the standard high, and they wanted to be good this year, and they definitely achieved that.
Bridgeport and Hartington Cedar Catholic coming up today, first round of the C2 playoff bracket. We'll dive into this matchup when we come back right after this with more with Bridgeport coach Jeremy Reimers. We're back on our High Plains.
Hi, I'm Michelle Perkins of RE/MAX Regency. After branching out, I've returned home to my roots, to the land from which I came and my family has held for 5 generations.
Michelle truly understands what home means and treats you like family as she guides you through the buying and selling process, bringing the latest pricing tools that are not currently being used in this area to sell your home at the highest price in the least amount of time, and to ensure that you do not overpay when buying.
So just give me a call, kick back, Remax, and settle down.
This chair is way too big.
It's perfect for us.
This one's tiny. That's because it's mine.
Hey, this chair is just right.
This bed is way too hard.
It's perfect for me.
This bed is way too soft.
Just what I needed.
This bed is just right.
So come on over to Leaf Heads.
Many people count on space heaters and electric blankets to help stay warm in the winter. Here are a few safety tips. Space heaters need space all around them. Only buy space heaters that are tested and labeled by a national recognized facility. Before using a space heater or electric blanket, inspect the cord for cracks or warm spots. Finally, turn off electric blankets when not in use. Space heaters and electric blankets can provide needed comfort or can be deadly if not used with care. So use caution this winter season. This message is brought to you by Chimney Rock Public Power District, your Touchstone Energy partner, the power of human connections.
You may look forward to spending the seasons with family in your home, but not when these critters come knocking on your door. That's where Benzel Pest Control saves the day. Family-owned since 1976, we provide prompt, professional, and efficient services to keep your home or business safe and secure all year round.
With three generations and more than four decades of service to the Nebraska Panhandle and Southeast Wyoming, Benzel Pest Control is the only name in all seasons pest defense.
We're back with more on our pregame show ahead of kickoff with Bridgeport and Hartington Cedar Catholic. Coach, let's dive into this matchup. Hartington Cedar Catholic comes in right now with a record of 7-2. Lost two of their last three games, but Oakland Craig and Norfolk Catholic combined 13-3. How good of an opponent is this for you today?
They're a good opponent for us. We're looking at a very good defensive team. Offensively, they like to run the ball, but they're definitely a team we're going to compete with because I feel like our defense can compete with anyone this year that we see in the postseason. Our kids have done a really good job on that side of the ball. And so I really do like the matchup. Their big thing is run the ball. And our biggest, best part of our defense all year has been stopping the run. We've given up an average of 45 yards per game. And that was even against a team included in the season, which was St. Pat's. And all they do is run the ball. Now we lost that game, but, our defense has been really, really good all year long.
So strength on strength, when your defense is on the field, let's talk a little bit about your offense. And you're gonna keep it fairly ground-oriented. Cole Fessler has approaching 1,200 yards on the season. Your quarterback, Braden Stoll, up around 400. So you've got a nice 1-2 punch there. Talk about what makes Cole such a dynamic runner.
He just has vision that you can't teach. It's quite an awesome thing to watch him play. We were playing Hershey last week, and I don't know how he ended up finding the end zone one time. He just weaved and bopped out of the bunch of different places, and all of a sudden he was in the end zone. He just has this vision and being able to make the right cut at the right time. I mean, he's just a really good player for us. Does a lot of really good things.
And while you're a ground-oriented team, you can still do some damage in the air. Stoll averages over 100 yards a game passing, and you hit some big plays, 17 yards per pass completion. So you like to, you know, pound it and then raise up and hit that big play, it looks like.
Yeah, we like to play action and some different things, and Braden has really done a great job for us. I feel like he's kind of changed the offense this year with the option game and some different things that we do, and then being able to hit the big play down the field, making the right decision.
Wrapping up with Jeremy Reimers, head football coach for Bridgeport. Coach, let's get you out of here on this one with a quick key to the game brought to you by Team Auto Center, home of the lifetime.
9:05 to go. Clock now getting inside nine as they'll go to doubles both sides, wide side to the left. Moving left to right from the shotgun. Taney looking left all the way. Now steps up through the middle, avoids a tackler, and will have the first down and more. He's across midfield. He's inside the 40. He's to the 34-yard line before he goes down for the third first down for Cedar Catholic as he eluded the pressure and made it for the first down. No score in the ball game. 8:38, clock running as the chains are set, far side. Wide side to the left, but the twin receivers split in and slot, come to the right side. Straight I formation this time. Hookstein and Becker behind the quarterback. It'll be Becker, bounces it outside, is forced back in by the defensive end and will plunge to the 30-yard line. Picks up about four again. So second down, six now, after successfully making two third down conversions for this team. In the line, Jacob Rohan, the senior at 290 at center. Guards are Hunter Taney, a junior at 190, and Ethan Becker, a junior at 180. We'll get the rest of the starting lineups to you here shortly. From the shotgun, it's the option play. Quarterback faked, kept it, goes up the middle, and is going to have a couple of yards, very hard fought, out of this one. We'll call it the 28, so third down, 4 yards to go. Starting lineups brought to you by Western Nebraska Community College. From diplomas to degrees, it's for me. Learn more at wncc.edu. Tackles, Connor Hookstein, a junior at 250. Jay Steffen, a sophomore at 255 for Cedar Catholic. Nearly half of the quarter gone. Option play left side again, and Taney cuts back in, slides out of a tackle, and is right at the line to gain. Looks like he has it again, but we'll see as they come up at the 24 and say, yes, he made it. So it's the third successful first or third down conversion that we've seen out of this team. Cedar Catholic looking good on third down conversion so far in the ballgame. The ends are Connor Vlach, a senior at 190, and Miles Taney, the senior at 180. We've already mentioned his name once in the ballgame on a reception. Shotgun looking to throw. Swinging it out left side. Ball will be caught by Miles Taney again. And Taney is driven out of bounds, but not until he reaches the 15-yard line. That'll be near the line to gain again. We'll call it second, just over 1 yard to go. Is Cedar Catholic an impressive drive? The backfield, as we've already mentioned, Tate Taney, the junior at 185. Kirby Hochstein, senior at 150. And Easton Becker, a junior at 190. Along with Charlie Schroeder, a junior at 190 at the slot. Hand off Becker in the backfield. He's going to be hit and brought down by Brady Newkirk for a loss on the play. Newkirk pouring through there, made the tackle just as the handoff between Taney and Becker was accomplished. And that'll be at the 16-yard line. So third down, a couple to go. So again, a third down situation here. Third down and two. Half of the quarter gone on this opening drive. Quarterback keeper up the middle, and Taney's got it, despite Newkirk grabbing on from behind. Cade Loomis came over to help out, but again, a first down, the fifth of the ball game for Cedar Catholic here, and they have converted all four times on third down on this drive. Moving left to right, south to north. I formation this time. Hochstein, the fullback. It'll be the deep back Becker. Hit in the back. No, it was a fake. It's kept by Taney, and he's going to be slammed down. Cade Loomis got through first, but there were several teammates helping out, and Taney is going to lose yardage on the play. The 14th play of the drive. But it will be second down and 16 to go. Shotgun again. Man coverage in the secondary. Looking left, throwing, and it will be dropped by the receiver trying to make a diving catch far side. Safe throw that time, but unable to come up with it was Noah Ahrens, and it'll bring up third down. Now we go to third and 16. 5 minutes, 7 seconds to go. No score, first quarter of play. Taney takes the snap, looking left, now looks right. He's hit as he throws the balls in the air, and it's intercepted. The ball is picked off by Cade Loomis. Taney was hit as he went to throw, and the first turnover of the ball game as it comes on the 16th play of the drive. 4-for-4 on third down conversions. One thing about Cedar Catholic we noticed early, 50% success ratio on the season on third downs and on fourth downs if they have to go for it. Now Bridgeport has it. Braden Soule will be in a shotgun as Nichols and Fessler. It'll be Bell, I guess it is, up the middle. Let's hold on and see as we get the name. Nichols was one of three listed as the starting fullback, but they had him listed in a couple of different positions, and it was Damian Bell who carries. And Bell has it to the 35-yard line. So from the 30 to the 35-yard line, second down, about five to go for Bridgeport on their opening possession of the ball game. They took over halfway through the quarter. Now four backs in a line in the shotgun. Stoll takes the snap, gives it to Fessler left side. He has to cut back into the middle and will have a couple of hard-fought yards out of this one. Looks to be the 37-yard line, so it'll bring up the first third down of the ball game for Bridgeport. Third down, 3 yards to go. The back of the football touching right at the 37. They need to get within an eyelash of the 40 for a first down. So Bridgeport with a wide side to the right, moving right to left, south to north. They'll flank Braxton Swires to the right, straight eye otherwise. Bell is the fullback. Fessler the I-back. It's Fessler. He's hit. Struggles forward. Does not look like he got it. He's going to be short by about a football's length the way it appears. So it'll bring up fourth down and 1 yard to go. Fourth and one. And apparently the punting team coming on for Bridgeport. But let's see. Fessler is the punter. Stands about 14 yards behind his center, Jake Wallison. Single safety for Cedar Catholic. Long count, hoping Cedar Catholic comes off. They don't. And the kick is lofted in the air. Far side, pulls out on the right side, cuts back in, lost his footing. And we'll get back to the line of scrimmage for a second down and 10 situation. In the backfield, as we said, could have been Mason Nichols, Damian Bell, both fullbacks listed as the coach had Damian, in fact, in about two or three different places. Cole Fessler, the I-back, Braxton Swires is the flanker for Bridgeport. Again, WNCC sponsoring our starting lineups. Four backs lined up in a row. Two on the right, one on the left to the quarterback Stoll. He'll take it right side. That's a quarterback run all the way. Steps out of a tackle, moves on forward, and has the first down over the 30-yard line and will be to nearly the 33, depending on where the spot goes. Looks like we may have a flag right where the tackle ended. We do. Face mask on Cedar Catholic. So the gain on the play will go to the 32-yard line, which will be a first down. And then the
Fly United Airlines, operated by SkyWest with Western Nebraska Regional Airport. United is dedicated to going the extra mile for you with daily flights to and from Denver, along with a commitment to excellent service. Reserve your flight today, and remember, United miles can be earned and redeemed with your flights. While at the airport, stop and enjoy authentic Italian food at Roma Italian Restaurant. Plus, Hertz Thrifty Car Rental is there for your car rental needs. Make life easier, relax, and get on board with Western Nebraska Regional Airport.
Coverage of today's game on KNEB.TV is brought to you by Chimney Rock Chiropractic. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. Farmer State Bank. And by Corman Seed Company.
Gosh dang it. have their second first down of the ball game. Step off this time is a major. So 5 and 15 on face masks against Cedar Catholic, and that takes it down to the 44-yard line of Cedar Catholic. So Cedar Catholic on defense, giving up one inadvertent and one ruled as the flagrant face mask. Shotgun formation here for Stoll again. Backs on both sides of him. Bell will take the handoff, plows straight ahead, and is going to have a couple out of this one as Cedar Catholic right there. Kirby Hochstein was first to greet him, but there were several. Gain of 2, second down, 8 yards to go. Second and 8 for Bridgeport. Just over 11 minutes to go, no score. First quarter of play, or second quarter of play now. First half's moved quickly. Again, the shotgun. Fessler will be on the left side, Bell on the right this time. On second and long. Running right side on the option, Stoll is hit in the backfield and is going to be dragged down. And we're going to have a horse collar called this time. The tackle was made by Easton Becker, but they're going to call that as a horse collar, I believe. The official on the near side, as the play was coming toward him, threw it. Now goes over to the referee to consult. Defensively for Hartington, they run a four-man front. Anthony Stamen and Cade Loomis are the ends. Brady Newkirk, Colt Rogers, the tackles. Damian Bell, Kaysen Loomis, the linebackers. See, Braden Stoll, Braxton Swires. Excuse me, that's Bridgeport we're talking now. And then Jake Wallison, Dylan Metz, Cole Fessler in the backfield for Hartington. They run a three-man front with four linebackers. Step off takes it to the 29-yard line. First down again. And two major penalties coming on this drive against Hartington. Hand off Fessler, cuts back into the middle. Good pursuit by the offside linebacker there to prevent that from being an even bigger play. Owen Hymus got in to make contact, but not until about a 5-yard gain on the play from the 29 to the 24. So second down, 5 yards to go. Bridgeport trying to break a scoreless deadlock, moving left to right, north to south here in the second quarter. Again, four backs will line up, two of them on the right-hand side of Braden Stoll, one on the left. Fessler, the leading ground gainer this year. High snap, but having it as Stoll, he's going to run into a bunch of traffic there and goes down hard, kind of twisted awkwardly as he hit. He will have nothing on the play, maybe lost a football length. So it will be third down and 5 yards to go. 9:39 clock running here in the first half of play. Ball on the right hash. Two receivers go to the left side for Bridgeport. Swires and Metz. Shotgun. Backs on both sides of the quarterback. Braden Stoll, the sophomore. He'll keep it. Pitches at the lake, and it'll be Fessler, and good pursuit by Cedar Catholic's going to wrap that one up for no gain on the play. Faked up the middle to try and freeze a linebacker, but they were running with the flow to the far side. And the ball back at the 25 now, so fourth down and 6 yards to go for Bridgeport. Bridgeport going for it on fourth, as you can hear the wind whistling in the background. It's coming into the face of Bridgeport now from the south. Fourth down, about 6, doubles to the right, and the snap is low, picked up by the running back who is going to be blocking, and Fessler is going to have nothing out of the play. So the ball will go over on downs. And Cedar Catholic, with 8.5 minutes to go, second quarter, has the ball. They'll take over at their own 25-yard line. So Fessler, nice job just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Taney in the shotgun. That's Tate Taney. He'll hand it away, and bouncing to the right side is Miles Taney, and he's got a huge gain out of this one. Near midfield, he fumbles the ball, but it goes out of bounds, and it will stay in Cedar Catholic's possession. As he was going down, the ball came out, but went out at the Bridgeport 49-yard line. That'll be the seventh first down for Cedar Catholic in the ball game. No score, 8:21 to go in the quarter. Miles Taney carrying for the first time. Usually plays tight end, but they had him in the backfield that time, as he is on this particular possession. Aarons is the flanker to the short side of the field. Ball on the left hash. Long count. And it'll be Becker up the middle, and he's going to lug people with him to the 43-yard line. 6-yard pickup will mean second down, 4 yards to go for Cedar Catholic. Well, they didn't give him a very generous spot. It'll be the 44, so second down and 5. Chuck Swartz with you in the Logos broadcast booth here at Bridgeport. First round playoff game. Ball on the left hash, wide side to the right, second and 5. I formation this time. Deep back, that's Becker. He tries to bounce it outside, does so. Gets around the corner, and Braden Stoll will push him out of bounds, but not until Cedar Catholic has their 8th first down of this first half. Spotted out at the 34-yard line, so a 10-yard pickup for the quarterback there. Tate Taney came into this ball game with 704 yards rushing, 5.4 average. We've got a timeout taken here. Okay, we'll take a timeout here also. 7:34 to go. No score on the West Coast scoreboard.
When you call Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating, you will have options. Repair it, rebuild it, or update it. Whether your furnace stops working or your bathtub won't drain, Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating provides the services you need to be comfortable. Weekends, holidays, or late nights, we will be there. With over 30 years of service, our certified technicians and cutting-edge technology can keep your systems running at their peak efficiency. Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating, every time we enter your home, we leave it a better place to live.
At Renewal by Anderson, it's about our people. We're a family-owned local company with the best windows, patio doors, and installation teams anywhere. But before our customers ever get to installation, they speak with our advisors in the office. We're so proud of our people. They're very experienced, organized, and at Renewal by Anderson, we know that our customers' time is so valuable. We assure you signature service from the first phone call to the installation day. Renewal by Anderson, a local family company. It's about our people.
As play resumes, Becker carries the ball from his I-back slot and is going to have minimal yardage on the play. Looks to be about a yard to the 33-yard line of Bridgeport. Second down, 9 yards to go. Cedar Catholic taking the time out there and talking things over, but it didn't work very well. We'll see what happens now as we've got a wide out left. Double tights. Shotgun, high snap, but handling it easily. And here comes Miles Taney again after taking the handoff from Tate Taney. And he'll have the ball to the 29-yard line for a 4-yard pickup. Third down, 5 yards to go. So far, 4 out of 5 on third down conversions for Cedar Catholic in the ball game. 4 on that opening possession that ended as the quarterback was hit and the ball lazily rose in the air and was intercepted. Up under center this time, it'll be the bubble pass right side. Caught by Miles Taney, and he will be brought down before he can get the first down. Be at the 26-yard line, a 3-yard pickup brings up 4th down and 2 yards to go. So 4th and 2, wind at their back. Cedar Catholic, a team that has succeeded 50% of the time on 4th downs through the regular season. Ball's on the right hash. They'll be in the Maryland eye. 2 fullbacks and an I-back. Tate Taney gives it to the deep back. Becker tries to hurdle, and he's going to be close. It'll depend as they come in from the sides, the linesmen, as they agree on where the spot was. Easton Becker did everything he could, and it's close enough that they'll peer at it and say first down. So first down number 9 for Cedar Catholic. No score in the ball game. 5:42 to go. You have to remember, Bridgeport has not given up any points since that 17-14 loss to St. Pat's. 3 shutouts since then. Deep back, Becker again. Oh, he cuts it back to the right. Has a nice opening. Linebackers get there quickly, but not before about a 5-yard pickup on the play. Kaysen Loomis will be in on the tackle. Let's see, the 24 to the 18, the way it looks. Second down. It'll be the handoff again as Cedar Catholic trying to get the Bridgeport defense moving the other direction, but they stayed home. Fessler was one of the last to get up for Bridgeport there. And from the 24 to the 21-yard line is where it'll be. So third down. About 2 to go, not quite. Shotgun snap. It'll be Miles Taney, and he's got a huge opening. He's into the end zone. Miles Taney scores with 4 minutes and 18 seconds to go in this first half of play. And Bridgeport trails for only the second time this season. So Miles Taney PAT kick will be from Blake Ahrens. Juniors kicked their PATs all season. Low snap, but handled nicely. Kicks in the air. And it makes the score 7-0. So it is Cedar Catholic with 4:18 to go in the half. 7, Bridgeport, nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
Coverage of today's game on KNEV.TV is brought to you by Chimney Rock Chiropractic. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. Farmers State Bank. And by Corman Seed Company.
Nothing. Cedar Catholic on top. For more than 125 years, Wells Fargo's advisors has created wealth management and investment strategies aimed at achieving our clients' personal financial goals. Call Ryan Wendor, 632-7561. Bounding kick taken at the 18-yard line. Fessler trying to bounce to the outside, hesitates, couldn't get the blocks he needed, but will be to the 30-yard line before he goes down. So Bridgeport will have 4 minutes and 11 seconds left here in the first half of play, trailing 7-0, and will be at their own 30-yard line, 70 yards away from pay dirt. Coach Reimers in the pregame said that he felt that it was going to be pretty good defenses going up against each other, although both offenses have had their moments this year. Shotgun for sophomore Braden Stull. Stull, rolling right, has a lot of pressure. Trying to elude it, can't, at a shirt tail tackle, will bring him down. That's clear back at the 19-yard line is where forward progress will be spotted. So it's going to bring up second down, 21 yards to go. Good defense by Hartington Cedar Catholic that time. Ethan Becker in on the stop. End and slot to the left. Same situation to the right. Fessler, the running back, by Stoll on second and long. It's a designed quarterback run. He tries to split the defense, has it over the 30. Gain back the lost yardage and will be to the 33-yard line. It'll bring up third down, 7 yards to go. He was knocked out of bounds, so the clock stops with 3:22 remaining. Key to the game by Team Auto Center, the home of the lifetime warranty on every new vehicle, Team Auto Center. And Reimer said, probably the fact that both defenses have bent but not really broken. And it'll be which offense can solve that mystery. Third down, 7. A little more manageable than it was a moment ago. Stoll looks, slides through, but in pressure goes down as he will lose back to the original line. No, in fact, back to the 29-yard line. A 4-yard loss. And it'll be fourth down and 11 yards to go. So an apparent punting situation for Bridgeport deep in their own territory. Inside a minute to go, and clock stop now as they have called a timeout. We'll hold it here because they've been taking inordinately short breaks, the officiating crew, and we've come back just as a play is developing, so we'll hold it here on fourth down as an apparent punt will be coming. Ball game being played here in Bridgeport. If Bridgeport would win, they would host Oakland Craig if they win, or travel to Crofton next week. And Hartington Cedar Catholic would be at Oakland Craig with a win, or host Crofton next week. So back for the second time to punt will be Cole Fessler. First time it was a 40-yarder. This time into the wind and twin safeties to try and keep him from being able to kick it away and let it roll for a while. Helmet high snap, not a lot of rush, and the ball spirals down and will hit at the 42. Trickle sideways now and will be downed at the 39-yard line. So that'll be a 32-yard punt, no return. And Cedar Catholic has time, 3 minutes, 2 seconds to go, and a relatively short field, their own 39-yard line. As last time, they had a 10-play, 75-yard drive for the only score of the game. Shotgun formation. Taney will hand it, and that's going to be Miles Taney, and he breaks some tackles, breaks more, and he's into Bridgeport territory. Hesitates and will finally be knocked down near the 38 of Bridgeport. Fine run there, 23 yards by Miles Taney. He had the touchdown just a short time ago, and it'll be another first down, the 11th for Cedar Catholic. They won't waste any time. 2:40 to go. Rolling right. Tate Taney throws, and it will be caught, but knocked down immediately as Carter Ahrens. The forward progress will take him to the 34-yard line. So a 4-yard pickup. Second down, 6 yards to go. Clock continuing to run. We're at 2:15. As Tate Taney takes the snap, now rolls to the right, trying to get to the outside, and he'll be knocked out of bounds by Kaysen Loomis. He'll be near the 32-yard line for a 2-yard pickup. So third down, 4 yards to go, 2 yards on the scramble. That did stop the clock, of course, going out of bounds, so 2:07 remaining. Third down. Cedar Catholic 5 out of 7 on third downs in the ballgame. They'll be in an I formation. Hookstein, the fullback. Becker, the I back. Tate Taney, long count. Toss sweep left side. That'll be Becker. Nothing there. He's going to reverse his field, and he could have a big play coming here. He's to the 25, 20. Cuts in and is inside the 15-yard line before he goes down. Everybody pursued as he swept left as Cedar Catholic looked at it, bounced it back right side, and has the ball to the 18-yard line. That'll be a 14-yard pickup and the 12th first down for Cedar Catholic in the ball game. Hand off, Miles Taney up the middle. He's become a workhorse, originally started at the end. He'll be pushed back, but not until he reaches about the 8-yard line. And a timeout is taken. We'll take a timeout here also. 7-0 Cedar Catholic on the West Coast scoreboard.
Logos and Gearing is the place to get all of your school spirit gear, personalized gifts, and promotional items for your business and employees and banners for any special event. Logos is also the only place to stop for custom screen printing or embroidery. You can even design it yourself on their interactive website. Stop into Logos today. They'll design it, print it, and have it to you in no time. There's no job too big or small for Logos. That's Logos in Gearing.
HydroZen. Unplug and recharge. What is HydroZen? It's total body relaxation. It's total body recharge. It's floating weightless on water. Floating your aches, pains, stresses, and worries away. HydroZen is a revolutionary new therapy using Epsom salt saturated water as a way to relax and rejuvenate your body. And it's now available in Scotts Bluff. It is for most ages and has many benefits to the mind and body. Visit HydrozenFloat.com or call us at 308-63-FLOAT.
Tate Taney firing a pass on the far side. That'll be enough for a first down as it's caught by Noah Ahrens that time. There are several Ahrens on the team. Noah makes the catch, and that will mean first down and goal from about the 2-yard line. So the 13th first down for Cedar Catholic, and we're going to have another timeout taken here. Minute 23 to go here in the half. We'll take a timeout. 7-0 Cedar Catholic on the West Coast scoreboard.
I've struggled with my weight since I was 13, but weight loss surgery changed my life. I've lost 120 pounds, 80 inches, and gained a whole new outlook on life.
Weight loss surgery may be the answer to your weight and health problems. Regional West offers the support of skilled surgeons and a dedicated bariatric team for your journey to a healthier you. Learn more about weight loss options at Regional West. It's time for a new you.
Coverage of today's game on KNEB.TV is brought to you by Chimney Rock Chiropractic. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. Farmers State Bank. And by Corman Seed Company.
Find out what convenient really means at the Western Travel Terminal. Start with our great selection of food and drinks, from For Real milkshakes and fresh brewed coffee to snacks and hot food. Next, check out our beer and spirits with their everyday low prices. Finally, let us work for you with our full-service gas station and automatic truck and car wash. All this can be found at 822 South Beltline in Scotts Bluff. Western Travel Terminal, your convenient shopping, restaurant, and full-service gas leader.
Welcome to Kelly's, home of the Valley's best selection of wine, spirits, and beer. Whether you're brand loyal to the tried and true brew or really enjoy trying something different and new, Kelly's has something for everyone. Family owned and operated and right on your way on West 27th Street in Scotts Bluff. Kelly's Liquor. If you can't find it at Kelly's, it's not worth drinking.
Minute 18 to go in the half. Here's the kick with the wind. It'll be a driving kick down to the 10-yard line. Taken in by Metz, and as he tries to come to the near side, is tackled at the 20, and again, a yellow flag comes out on the tackle. But 14-0, Cedar Catholic dominating with the wind at their back in the second quarter of play. Remember, at halftime, we'll look at the C2 football playoff bracket. And again, we're going to have a face mask penalty called against Cedar Catholic. Those have been the only Mars that we've seen for them defensively, and it is a major penalty. So their fourth penalty, three of them 15-yard face masks. One was just stepped off for 5 yards. So with a minute and 10 seconds to go, Bridgeport going into the wind at their own 35-yard line. End in slot right. I formation, Fessler the deep back. Toss sweep, Fessler left side. He's going to be hit in the backfield. Breaks out of a tackle momentarily, but then comes down as Blake Ahrens, Jr., will get the tackle. And there are 54 seconds remaining in the half after a loss back to the 31-yard line. Second and 14. Quick synopsis. We'll go over some of this at halftime, but Bridgeport 0 for 3 on third downs right now. Cedar Catholic 6 out of 8. End and slot. Wide right. Ball not quite in the center of the field, favoring the left side hash mark. Shotgun. It'll be a handoff. Bell, and he's going to be brought down quickly. Hookstein gets a hold of him after a gain of a couple to the 33-yard line. So it'll bring up third and a dozen. And I think Bridgeport's just going to let the clock run out, and we'll be at halftime. That's what it'll be. So a 14-point second quarter for Cedar Catholic has given them a 2-touchdown lead in this ball game over Bridgeport. Again, at halftime, we will be looking at the playoff bracket. We'll look at some of the team stats that we have. Doing it by myself, I'm not able to keep all individual totals for you either, so we'll be going through all of that. But we've got a full halftime coming up for you. Again, our score, Hartington Cedar Catholic 14 and Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
For the past 44 years, Platte Valley Vacuum and Sewing has been serving the Wyobraska area. That's quite a long time. At Platte Valley Vac and Sew, you'll find quality sewing machines, quilting and embroidery machines, even sergers from name brands such as Pfaff and Baby Lock, both known for their well-made machinery. Keep in mind, you'll receive one-on-one lessons with your machine purchase. Platte Valley Vac and Sew also offers a fine selection of 100% cotton quilting fabrics and a great selection of threads and notions to assist you in most any quilting or embroidery project you might have. For all your sewing machine quilting needs, stop by Platte Valley Vac and Sew, downtown Scotts Bluff.
Blacksbute General Hospital continues our mission to lead and innovate in healthcare delivery and community wellness. But this isn't just a hospital. This is home to exceptional patient care. This is the greatest place to work, receive care, and practice medicine. This is innovation in action. This is community wellness. This is where specialty clinics fit your needs. This is where a friendly smile, a warm hand, and an empathetic ear exist to care for you. We are Blacksbute General Hospital. This is us. Great things are happening here since 1976.
Coverage of today's game on KNEB.TV is brought to you in part by Corman Seed Company. Farmers State Bank. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. And by Chimney Rock Chiropractic.
Chuck Swartz with you in the Logos broadcast booth. Stop into Logos. The guys will custom design it, print it, and have it ready for the game. There's no job too big or small for Logos in downtown Gearing. 14-0. We'll recap scoring here in a bit as Bridgeport gave up two touchdowns in the second quarter. Most points they've given up this year, 17, in their 17-14 loss to St. Pat's, their only blemish during the regular season. But Hartington Cedar Catholic only losing to two very fine football teams late in the year, both in the playoffs, Oakland Craig at 7-1 and Norfolk Catholic at 6-2. Let's look at the Hartington Cedar Catholic schedule. They defeated O'Neill 19-16. Not really an indicator, as O'Neill only won one game all year, and Hartington Cedar Catholic got by him by three, then beat Battle Creek, a 6-3 team, perennial playoff team, in overtime, 24-21. Then beat Takema Herman, 50-15, won at David City, 21-13. Won at BRLD, 50-8. Defeated Crofton, who is playing Oakland Craig today, 29-14. Oakland Craig won over Cedar Catholic, 52-14. Then won at Ponca, 46-14, and Cedar Catholic closed out the regular season, losing to Norfolk Catholic, 14-10. So 7-2, 11th seeded. Bridgeport, the sixth seed, won at Sydney, 35-7. Then shut out Centura in one of only three home games for Bridgeport, 40-0. The game at Holyoke, Colorado was canceled. They won at Gibbon, 27-0. Lost at home to North Platte St. Pat's, 17-14. Won at Gordon Rushville, another shutout, 28-0. Won at Valentine on another shutout, 20-0. The Chase County game at home, which would have been their fourth home game, was canceled. And then won against Hershey, 37-0. So five shutouts on the year, but they won't have one today as Cedar Catholic has two touchdowns up to lead it. We'll recap that scoring and look it over when we come back. Hartington Cedar Catholic 14, Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
Exceptional care right here at home. That's the mission of Morrill County Community Hospital. Morrill County Community Hospital is a 20-bed critical access hospital that owns and operates clinics throughout Bridgeport, including specialty outreach clinics and Morrill County Home Health Clinic, as well as Chimney Rock Medical Center, located in Bayard. Our dedicated team is committed to you and our community every time at Morrill County Community Hospital, Bridgeport, Nebraska.
Coverage of today's game on KNEB.TV is brought to you in part by Corman Seed Company. Farmers State Bank. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. And by Chimney Rock Chiropractic.
The holidays are a time to connect with family, with friends, with each other. After a busy year, the holidays are a perfect time for laughing together, playing together, talking together, and celebrating together. Spend time this holiday season connecting with the people that mean the world to you, and let us take care of the connectivity.
Are you looking for the perfect place to hold a wedding, family reunion, holiday office party, or business meeting? Well, look no further. The Hampton Inn and Suites Hotel and Conference Center is just the place for you. We're a full-service banquet facility that can host up to 400 of your guests. Stop in and see our spacious open concept meeting rooms and begin planning your special event or family gathering today. Let us do the work for you so you can enjoy your guests. For personal service, stop by the Hampton Inn and Suites front desk.
14-0, Hartington Cedar Catholic leading Bridgeport at halftime. Monument Physical Therapy in Gearing offers the Bumps and Bruises program, offering one free consultation and one free follow-up for all area athletes. Monument Physical Therapy in Gearing. A scoreless first quarter, and then with 4:18 to go in the second, Miles Taney scores from 21 yards out for Cedar Catholic. Aarons adds the PAT. That would be Blake Aarons. And it's 7-0, a 10-play, 75-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 12 seconds. Then exactly 3 minutes later, Becker scores from 3 yards out. Again, Aaron's on the kick, 14-0. That was a 7-play, 61-yard drive that took 1 minute and 44 seconds off of the clock. So right now, Cedar Catholic in command. The wind has picked up some from the south, kind of quartering across from the southwest, but whichever team has it at their backs will have an advantage. And in Bridgeport's case, that'll only be for one of those 12-minute periods in the third quarter. Russell's Automotive, also helping bring you the game today, your family-owned go-to for all of your quality automotive repair needs. When we come back, we'll take a complete look at the C2 football playoff bracket, which will culminate at Memorial Stadium on Tuesday, the 24th of November. Again, it's Cedar Catholic 14, Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
Coverage of today's game on KNEV.TV is brought to you in part by Corman Seed Company. Farmers State Bank. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. And by Chimney Rock Chiropractic.
Compliments for you and your home invites you to the Holiday Open House, October 30th through November 7th. Let us take you on a tour and help you find the perfect gift. From tree decorations to carolers, get great savings throughout the store and brighten up your home for all your special occasions. We'll also have door prizes and refreshments. Join us October 30th through November 7th for the Holiday Open House at Compliments for You and Your Home, 1708 Broadway, downtown Scotts Bluff.
Looking at the playoff picture on games that will be on the KNEB stable of stations, Scotts Bluff, the number 12 seed at Aurora at 6 Mountain Time. That'll be on the trail, 106.9. Currently on the trail, and Jeff has this ball game. Mitchell, the number 10 seed at number 7 Wahoo, and Wahoo leads the game 34-14 in the fourth quarter of that one against Scotts Bluff tonight at 6 Mountain Time. In C2, top seed Archbishop Bergen against 16th seed Lincoln Lutheran. That'll be this evening. Number 9, North Platte St. Pat's at number 8, Sutton tonight. This is the top half of the bracket. Number 5, Wilbur Claytonia against 12th seeded Grand Island Central Catholic tonight. 13th seeded Centura is at 4th seeded UTAN tonight. That's the top half of the bracket. Bottom half, third-seeded Oakland Craig taking on Crofton tonight. Winner of that game takes on the winner of this one. Hartington Cedar Catholic leading 14-0 over Bridgeport right now. Seventh-seeded Norfolk Catholic and 10th-seeded Aquinas Catholic tonight in Norfolk. And 15th-seeded Bishop Newman from Wahoo is... Looking at our stats brought to you by Paul Reed Construction. Paul Reed Construction and Supply has been in business for over 35 years. Located in Gehring, the company provides services ranging from commercial and industrial building construction to heavy highway earthwork and installation of underground utilities, along with the Rockpile Division, service and equipment. That's Paul Reed Construction. Well, right now, Cedar Catholic's offense, 6 out of 8 on third down, 1 for 1 on fourth down. Bridgeport is 0 for 3 on third downs, and they have punted twice in the ball game for a 36 average, 32 and 40-yard punts. Cedar Catholic has punted once, and that was a 43-yard punt. So those stats brought to you by Paul Reed Construction. They faked me out. I thought they already had the 3-minute warm-up period up on the board. They don't, so they are just now getting to that. So we've got a little time to fill in and remind you that Gehring will be at Aurora in volleyball coming up tomorrow, district final. Long trip for them. Scott's Bluff, the long trip to Aurora. For football this evening, Chris Cottrell making that trip. It'll be a second matchup between those two teams. Aurora won during the regular season. So we'll see what happens if Chris can bring back a winner. Again, that'll be on 106.9, the trail for you tonight. We should be wrapping up pretty quickly on that Mitchell ball game. They were trailing at Wahoo. As long trip for Jeff to go down and get that ball game in. We appreciate him being able to go down and cover that one. We're looking to see if we have an update on that. Potter Dix is taking on Wallace in football later on also. So some area teams still trying to advance here. But it's going to be a tough ladder to climb here for the Bridgeport Bulldogs, as Cedar Catholic's swarming defense right now has caused them all kinds of problems. In first downs at halftime, Cedar Catholic has 13 compared to 3 for the Bridgeport Bulldogs. Contact Jennifer Urdialis, your local 5-star lender with Castle & Cook Mortgage, for a simple, friendly, and fast loan process for your home purchase or refinance. Contact Jennifer today. Castle & Cook Mortgage, the key to your castle. Some of our other sponsors helping to bring you the ball game: Floyd's Truck Center, your commercial farm and feed truck center representing Freightliner, Western Star, and Harsh. They're at 322 South Beltline Highway East in Scotts Bluff. And Hydrotex is your lubrication solution partner, a member of the Holiday family of companies. Hydrotex is proud to support local athletes. Well, Cedar Catholic wearing their white traveling uniforms, the red helmets, red numerals, most of them red shoes. And, of course, Bridgeport, their purple tops, the gold pants with the blue and white stripe down the side with the white helmets. Bridgeport on the near side, the home side of the field. Cedar Catholic on the far side, and since Cedar Catholic received the opening kickoff, put together a 16-play drive that ended on a fourth down, and I think I had said they were one of one. They were one of two on fourth down. Cedar Catholic, they'll have one as Taney was hit as he was ready to throw, and the ball was intercepted. That's our only turnover. Right now, 4 penalties, 50 yards on Cedar Catholic, no penalties on Bridgeport. But Cedar Catholic with the important stat right now, 14-0 on the scoreboard. Ready to go, and Cedar Catholic will have the wind at their backs here in the third quarter of play. Swires on the near side, and the kick will...
it out. That's fine. Back. I don't really have to worry about adjusting too many of the clocks in my house because the ones that I use are usually from my phone, and I don't pay attention to the other ones. I don't think the time has ever really been right on our mic. One, though, I will have to fix. That is a life source. Our coffee pots, we had to go get a new one yesterday. The carafe broke. And the store website said that they had one in stock that we needed. Went to the store. It was not the one that I needed, so I ended up having to buy a whole new coffee pot. That was an emergency situation. We literally could not go without our coffee. You're hanging out with Cammie here on your Friday afternoon on your home for better country.
This year, make your holiday season just a little bit merrier with a cash. Valley Bank. You can save 1% on your Thanksgiving dinner, holiday shopping, as well as all of your everyday purchases all year long. With no annual fee, no balance transfer fee, and the security of having your local bank behind you, a Platte Valley Bank Visa Cashback Rewards credit card is the right choice. Save at the store and online. For more details or to apply, go to www.pvbank.com.
I've struggled with my weight since I was 13, but weight loss surgery changed my life. I've lost 120 pounds. 80 inches and gained a whole new outlook on life.
Weight loss surgery may be the answer to your weight and health problems. Regional West offers the support of skilled surgeons and a dedicated bariatric team for your journey to a healthier you. Learn more about weight loss options at Regional West. It's time for a new you.
Bring up second and 25 as the relentless pass rush of Cedar Catholic gets in. So back on their own side of the field now. 45. Needing to reach just about the 30 of Cedar Catholic for a first down. Now the big run by Fessler of 18 got him close enough where the quarterback sneak worked. It is second down, so they've got a couple downs, but they need to pick up some yardage. And it's Fessler again, but he will be brought down after a three-yard pickup, maybe four, depending on where the football was when he landed. It will be, 49. Four-yard pickup, third down, 21 yards to go. As Bridgeport converted their first third down conversion of the game. But now third and a bunch. Going into the wind. Doubles to both sides. Wide side to the left. Ball's on the right hash. Stuhl will have Fessler beside him in the shotgun. Man coverage by Cedar Catholic in the secondary. This time. And it's going to be aired out. It will be Swires who has it bobbled away at the last instant. Looked like he had it a minute. It was knocked away, and as he went to the ground, turned, and here was the ball coming down toward him, but it was not to be, and it'll bring up fourth down and 21 yards to go for Bridgeport. That would have been a huge, huge play. Back to punt, Fessler. He already punted once into the wind, a 38-yarder, as it was tipped by one of the receivers for Cedar Catholic and went on downfield. No rush on. High kick, far side. It will be bouncing back toward Bridgeport. So it will be downed, and Cedar Catholic will have it at the 27-yard line. At 27 is where they're going to put that one down. So first down and 10 for Cedar Catholic with 4 minutes, 49 seconds to go. 23-yard punt into the wind, and since it bounced back a bit, here's Taney in the shotgun. He'll keep it, pitches out on the kind of triple option, and Becker will have it to the 30, and we're going to have a penalty flag, apparently a block in the backfield. Well, it's holding is what the call will be. So what would have been a three-yard pickup will be negated. 4:43 remaining in the quarter, still 14-0. Cedar Catholic leading after those two second quarter touchdowns. Winner moves on to a second round game next week. Step off takes it back to the 18-yard line because it stepped off from the point of the infraction. So it will be first down for Cedar Catholic and about 18 to go. Going to the right side, Becker, world of steam, and he'll be downed as he crosses the 20 to the 21-yard line. So it'll be second down, 15 yards to go. Becker has had some good runs today for Cedar Catholic. Clock runs, of course, as he was inbounds on the tackle, 4:15. 14-0, Cedar Catholic leading. They'll put triple receivers left this time. Remember, the wind is kind of at the back of the quarterback. Now double receivers right, so an empty backfield for the quarterback, Tate Taney. Man coverage, of course, for Bridgeport. Here comes the rush and the miscommunication there as Noah Ahrens faked to the outside, cut up field, and the ball went sailing toward the sideline. So third down and 15 yards to go. Fast moving quarter. Haven't had any timeouts called, no scoring. So only 3:51 to go here in the quarter. Ball's on the right hash, wide side will be the left. But double receivers go to the right side, the short side of the field. Taney, one step drop, pump fakes, wants to throw deep. Nice spiral on the ball, but it's slightly overthrown. Just missed Schroeder. Charlie Schroeder, first intended pass for him today, as might have been a little bit of wind there carrying it just past where the quarterback Tate Bainey thought it would go. So 0 for 1 on thirds this time, but 6 of 9 on third down conversions for Cedar Catholic in the game. Second punt of the half, third of the game. High snap, leaps, has it, no rush, and he'll line drive this one downfield, and it's going to take a tremendous roll and finally goes out of bounds at approximately the 14-yard line. So that's a 65-yard punt. Obviously no return. We've had no returned punts today for either squad. And boy, you talk about flipping field position. With 3:37 to go in the quarter, our score is unchanged from halftime, 14-0. Cedar Catholic leading it. And Bridgeport faced with 86 yards if they're going to get anything done here. No first downs for Cedar Catholic this half. But they had 13 in the first half. It's a handoff up the middle. And nothing much coming, about a yard on the play. That's Fessler again. He'll have it to the 15 for second down and 9 yards to go. Just over 3 minutes to go as Bridgeport breaks the huddle. Backs on both sides of the quarterback, Braden Stuhl, the sophomore. Puts double receivers to the short side. Here come the linebackers. The pitch has to be given early, and Fessler's in trouble in the backfield, and he will go down. Linebacker forced the pitch, and Fessler had nowhere to go and is dropped back at the 11-yard line. 4-yard loss, third down and 13 to go. So third and a bunch for Bridgeport here from their own 11-yard line. And barring a first down, they'll be punting into the wind again, and that has been a huge factor. Cedar Catholic scored both times with the wind. Man in motion coming across. Stuhl waits for him to set near side. Throws, it will be caught, now fumbled, and they're going to say incomplete. Never had possession. Ball was in Swire's hand momentarily, but as he turned to come upfield for what looked like it would have been enough for a first down, it goes incomplete, and it will be a punting situation for Bridgeport. So Bridgeport 1 out of 7 on third down conversion. Cedar Catholic's done the job. Minute 55, last time a 23-yard punt. Nice snap, kick is away. Wind takes care of it for a moment, and a fair catch will be gathered in by Grant Ahrens, a sophomore for Cedar Catholic. And that ball will be spotted at the 43 for a 32-yard punt. So the ball comes over to Cedar Catholic in plus position here. They'll have the ball with a minute and 49 seconds to go. Third quarter action, 14-0, and they're at the Bridgeport 43-yard line. I formation, handoff to the deep back, Becker, and he crosses the 40-yard line of Bridgeport before being brought down at the 39. 4-yard pickup will mean second and half a dozen. Oh, now we got officials' time for a moment. Equipment repair injury. Looks like a muscle, the way the trainer is working. So we have a timeout. Minute 41 to go, third quarter. It's 14-0. Hartington Cedar Catholic leading on the West Coast scoreboard.
Home buying is filled with decisions. Neighborhood, floor plan,
fenced yard? Make one choice that's easy. Start with FNBO first. We'll guide you home. Home buying is filled with decisions. Square feet, fixer-upper, room to grow. Make one choice that's easy. Start with FNBO first. We'll guide you home.
At Elite Physical Therapy, we provide preventative and rehabilitative treatments that maximize function and promote well-being for patients of all ages. With two locations in Scottsbluff and Gearing, we offer the convenience of you choosing your location with the same great services no matter where you go. Stop into one of our locations today, in Scottsbluff at 214 West 27th Street or in Gearing at 10th and M Street, and see what Elite Physical Therapy can do for you. Treatment you need and care you deserve.
Well, good news. Cedar Catholic injury, getting up and walking off the field, is Ethan Becker, junior, as a lineman. Easton Becker is the running back. So second down, 6 yards to go. Man in motion crossing left to right in the formation. Toss sweep right side. That is Easton Becker, and he's going to have the first down. Shakes a tackle, stays on his feet, and is finally knocked out of bounds. Boy, it looked like Anthony Stamen. Last hope there for Bridgeport. And it will be all the way to the 18-yard line, a 21-yard pickup, 14th first down of the ball game for Cedar Catholic. Ball's on the right hash mark. Double receivers to the left. It's Becker again, and this time a short gain, but it seems like even when it appears to be a short gain, he picks up some positive yardage. Line of scrimmage was the 18. He'll be to the 16-yard line. Second down, 8 yards to go for Cedar Catholic. Already ahead 14-0. If they make it a three-score game and about a quarter to go as we're in the final minute, that will be tough for Bridgeport. Taney keeps it himself. The quarterback dances near the 10-yard line before he comes down. It won't be enough for the first down as he's to the 11, but a 5-yard pickup means third down and a short 3 yards to go the way it looks, as they just need to get between the 8 and 9 for a first down, and the ball's at the 11. Half a minute to go, third quarter. Taney will set up under center this time. Hookstein and Becker behind him on third and a short 3. Long count, give it to the first man, and it looks like with second effort there, Kirby Hookstein lunges within a yard or so. Now they're going to say his knee went down right on the 10-yard line. So only a yard gain. So fourth down, 2. Could be the play defensively here, but that was the end of the quarter. So after 3 quarters, it is Cedar Catholic 14, Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
Coverage of today's game on KNEV.TV is brought to you by Chimney Rock Chiropractic. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. Farmers State Bank. And by Corman Seed Company.
Hi, I'm Michelle Perkins of RE/MAX Regency. After branching out, I've returned home to my roots, to the land from which I came and my family has held for 5 generations.
Michelle truly understands what home means and treats you like family as she guides you through the buying and selling process, bringing the latest pricing tools that are not currently being used in this area to sell your home at the highest price in the least amount of time, and to ensure that you do not overpay when buying.
So just give me a call, kick back, RE/MAX, and settle down.
We go to the fourth quarter. Cedar Catholic now moving north to south, left to right, fourth down. about 2 yards to go. I formation, toss sweep. That's Becker around the right side. He's got blockers. He's got the first down and steps out of bounds shy of the end zone, but he's inside the 5-yard line. He'll be to the 4 for another first down. 15th first down of the ball game for the Hartington Cedar Catholic Trojans. They have looked impressive against a good defense. So Hartington Cedar Catholic only 4 yards away. And they're in for the touchdown now. That was Becker scoring. And it is a 20-0 game. A scoreless first, a scoreless third. But 11:49 in the fourth, Becker gets his second touchdown. This one from 4 yards out. A 7-play drive, same as the one he scored on in the second quarter. But a 43-yard drive as they started in plus position. Here's Blake Ahrens. Good snap. Boots up. And it is perfect. So, with 11:49 to go, it's Hartington Cedar Catholic 21, Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
This chair is way too big.
It's perfect for us.
This one's tiny. That's because it's mine.
Hey, this chair is just right.
This bed is way too hard.
It's perfect for me.
This bed is way too soft.
Ah, just what I needed.
This bed is just right.
So come on over to Leaf Heads.
Many people count on space heaters and electric blankets to help stay warm in the winter. Here are a few safety tips. Space heaters need space all around them. Only buy space heaters that are tested and labeled by a national recognized facility. Before using a space heater or electric blanket, inspect the cord for cracks or warm spots. Finally, turn off electric blankets when not in use. Space heaters and electric blankets can provide needed comfort or can be deadly if not used with care. So use caution this winter season. This message is brought to you by Chimney Rock Public Power District, your Touchstone Energy partner, the power of human connections.
You may look forward to spending the seasons with family in your home, but not when these critters come knocking on your door. That's where Benzel Pest Control saves the day. Family-owned since 1976, we provide prompt, professional, and efficient services to keep your home or business safe and secure all year round.
With 3 generations and more than 4 decades of service to the Nebraska Panhandle and Southeast Wyoming, Benzel Pest Control is the only name in all seasons pest defense.
Who is Hydrotex? Hydrotex manufactures and distributes over 300 different high-performance lubricants, including fuel conditioners, hydraulic and transmission fluid, and more. We've been helping customers improve their operations for more than 80 years with products made in the USA. We sell directly to customers and can even deliver right to your door to offer excellent service and value. Our products are made to exceedingly extend drain and grease intervals to reduce maintenance and labor costs to improve the budget. Whether you're in a factory, farm, fleet, or like to go fast, Hydrotex is here to help. Visit your local Hydrotex dealer in person or online today.
Thing out of that play. Defensive right side collapsed on that one in a hurry. Like Black may have been in on that one. I saw an 8 on the uniform before he turned away. If not, that would have been Hunter Taney, who's a junior. Another of the Taneys on this squad. Second down. 10 yards to go. Still shy of the 30-yard line. Double receivers left. One to the right. Stoll with 11 minutes to go. Takes the snap. Pressure on. Throws over the middle. He's got a man wide open and a big first down grab for Bridgeport there. That will be Dylan Metz, who made the catch in stride. He gets up rather gingerly. He has that right knee braced anyway, and he wants to come out, but he's going to go down on the ground, and the official will call timeout for an injured player. But with 10:59 to go, we'll hold it here for a moment because don't know how long these injury timeouts take, but that was a 21-yard pickup for the 7th first down for Bridgeport in the ball game. We're looking. I did not see an updated score on Wahoo and Mitchell. We'll check it again here. I think sometimes it backs up on me a little bit, and I get some of the day-old volleyball scores. But remember, we got Scott's Bluff and Aurora coming up tonight on the trail, 106-9. Chadron got beat by Kearney Catholic 41-0, and there is the final, Wahoo 34, Mitchell 14. Jeff Kelly had the call on that one on the trail. Long drive down there for him. And always seems to be a longer drive coming back, doesn't it, when you lose. But still being attended to is the receiver who made the nice catch there, Dylan Metz. He is up, but boy, not looking good as he's going to be helped off the field. Curtis Jackson and one of the coaches grabbing on there. Hydrotex is your lubrication solution partner, a member of the Holiday family of companies. Hydrotex is proud to support local athletes. Flanker right, I formation, double tight ends with 10:52 to go, first and 10, Bridgeport. Linebackers coming again. It'll be a toss and in trouble, trying to get outside and unable to do so is Cole Fessler. He'll be tripped up, stumbled back to the line of scrimmage, and brings up second down and 10 from midfield. Again, the linebackers coming up have just put so much pressure on, and you say, well, better be passing then. The times that Stoll has been back to pass, he has been harassed by the Trojans' defense. Second down, 10, plus maybe a football. Bell, the fullback. Fessler, the I-back. Stoll, the sophomore quarterback. Stoll, straight drop. Looking left, he's throwing a home run ball into traffic, and it'll be incomplete. Swires trying for it. Even though he was double covered, had a pretty good chance at that one. Noah Ahrens was one of the defenders for Cedar Catholic, and it'll bring up a third down and 10 situation. So far, Bridgeport is 1 out of 7 on third downs in the ball game. Ball slightly on the right side, not being used for the wide side as the receiver goes right. So a lot of room to the left. Man coverage by Cedar Catholic. Snap back. Stepping up in the pocket, getting rid of it just before the contact, and it's incomplete. Trying for the catch was Cole Fessler. Couldn't come up with it. He had 7 receptions on the regular season for 95 yards. That would have been enough for the first down. But unfortunately for Bridgeport, it goes incomplete and brings up fourth down and 10 with 9:56 to go. Fessler will be back to punt. Wendit is back, hoping to pin Cedar Catholic deep and perhaps a turnover. There's only been one in the game. Snap back. Here comes the rush. Kick is away. Angling it far side, and it'll go out of bounds. Let's see where they line him up as the referee spots the 22-yard line is where it'll be. So a 28-yard punt, and Cedar Catholic the ball at the 22-yard line. 9 minutes, 49 seconds remain. They lead it 21-0, and right now, just controlling the line of scrimmage for the most part, as the offense for Bridgeport has had troubles moving it. Tate Taney up under center. I formation behind him. Man in motion coming across is Schroeder. It'll be the deep back, and that'll be Becker again. Easton Becker totes the pigskin to the 25-yard line. Second down, 7 after the 3-yard pickup. And the clock at 9.5 minutes and clicking. When you're behind, it seems to speed along as the Bridgeport defense looks for a stop. Again, the I formation. Flanker way right. Toss sweep right. Becker. bottled in, now trying to cut back. He had success one time, but not this time, as he will be gang tackled at the 24-yard line. All that running to lose a yard on the play. Third down, 8 yards to go. First half, he had one where he started to the left. Defense had him pinned, so he just turned, went back to the right, and all of the pursuit was sealed off by the Cedar Catholic blockers, and he picked up a nice first down run. Here we are at third down, 8 yards to go from their own 24. Let's see if Thaney tries to throw into the wind here. Two receivers left in the shotgun. Long count. Looking left. Fires out on the side. Beautiful pattern, and it will be caught for Connor Vlatch's first catch of the game. He's knocked out of bounds, but not until a first down is achieved at the 38-yard line. 37, excuse me. They moved it back just a little, but a 13-yard pickup means first down number 16 in the game for Cedar Catholic. And with 8:23 to go, Bridgeport running out of opportunities here to get the ball back in time to put up multiple scores. End in slot right, ball on the left hash mark. First down and 10 from the 37 of Cedar Catholic. Shotgun. Thaney will keep it after faking to the back. He's throwing deep into the wind. It will be incomplete. Best chance at that was Braden Stoll, as he was closer to it than Shoemaker, but could not quite get to it. It'll go as an incompletion, and it's second down and 10 yards to go for Cedar Catholic. That does stop the clock, 8:16 remaining. There's been one turnover in the ball game. That was that interception when Thaney was hit as he tried to throw on the opening possession of the game. Since then, haven't been any. Couple balls on the ground near the sideline, but that was it. High formation again on second down. It's Becker coming to the right side. Gets a block. He's to the 40. 45 midfield and crosses into Bridgeport territory before he goes down at the 48-yard line. And the leading blocker there, Noah Ahrens, slow to get up, but he is up. But boy, a gain on the play of 15 to the Bridgeport 48-yard line. 17 first downs for Cedar Catholic, and 8 minutes to go in the ball game now as the chains set on the far side allow the clock to start. Ball's on the right hash, wide side left, and we've got a bunch set. Triple receivers over there, but all tightly bunched just outside the tackle. First and 10, toss sweep left. That was just extra blocking out there, and Becker takes advantage of it. He's to the 40 and is spun out of bounds finally by Kaysen Loomis. He'll be inside the 40 to the, well, I think they're going to put it down right at the 40. Let's see as they bring it in from the far side. Nope, 39-yard line. So it'll be second down and a yard to go. Becker picking up 9 on the play. He was out of bounds. Nope, he wasn't. They ruled him in when he was finally brought down. Now the official from this side wigwags the arms and comes over to talk to the referee for a moment. Yep, they're wanting to put a little more time on the clock as he had gone out of bounds on the far side. So. Blitz. It'll be a handoff to the deep back, Cole Fessler, and he is to the 45-yard line for a hard-fought 2 yards. Again, everything other than one run in my recollection has been very tough going for the senior running back for Bridgeport. Fessler coming in with 1,157 yards. Think about that. There's only 7 games as 2 were canceled due to the COVID. So he's averaging 144.6 a game. Nowhere close today against Cedar Catholic. End in slot left. Ball's near the right hash mark. Second down, 8 yards to go. Stoll in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Here comes the rush. Eludes it to the right. Has some room. Fakes a pass. Gets a little more cushion because of that. And crosses midfield. He'll be to the 49 of Cedar Catholic. Picks up six. It'll be third down and a couple for Bridgeport. 6 minutes, 16 seconds, clock running. We're nearly halfway through the fourth quarter here in a high school football game of 12-minute quarters. Third and two, two plus a football to be precise, needed by Bridgeport. End and slot left again, same formation. The ball's on the right hash. I formation. Stoll has had a quarterback sneak for a first down, but he'll give it away, and that will be first down for Fessler. Jab step took him back into the middle, and he'll tote it to the 45-yard line. Four-yard pickup, first down number eight for Bridgeport in the ball game, and their second successful third down conversion in the game. Two out of eight on thirds. 5:35, the clock racing. Swires comes left as the split receiver. Metz in the slot. Bell is the fullback. Fessler back to throw. Stoll sets up, and the ball's knocked out. That's a fumble, and it will be picked up by Hartington Cedar Catholic. Owen Hymus gets the recovery, and Stoll, shaken up on the play, is down. Trainer even for Cedar Catholic coming out, because as Stoll tried to set up from the blind side, he was belted as the ball came out. And the first turnover of the game against Bridgeport might be even more serious than that, because Stoll looks to be in obvious pain. Trainer for Cedar Catholic raced out there immediately. Cedar Catholic players taking a knee on the far sideline. And of course, Bridgeport's players and fans obviously concerned here also. It looks like we may have to take a longer break here, so we will take a timeout. It's Hartington Cedar Catholic 21, Bridgeport nothing on the West Coast scoreboard.
Some people think Allstate only protects your car. Here's the truth. Allstate can also protect your home or apartment, as well as your boat, motorcycle, RV, and snowmobile, and even your retirement and your life. Not many insurance companies can say that, but Allstate can.
Bundle and save with Allstate. In Gearing, call Allstate agent Michael Engelhop for a quote today at 308-436-2123.
The Verizon family is full of frowns because they're spending too much for their unlimited data and phones, while the Vieiro family is all smiles because they're getting four lines of unlimited data with two free Apple iPhone SE for mom and dad and two free LG K31 smartphones for the kids, all for just $100 a month. They're saving so much, they're able to get Fido. Find out how you can too at Vieiro.com or your nearest Vieiro store. Vieiro Wireless, keeping you connected.
Well, good news, Stoll is up, but didn't look real energetic coming to the sideline. He's shaken up. The fumble will give the ball to Cedar Catholic. First turnover for Bridgeport in the ball game, and it will be at the Bridgeport 46-yard line, first and 10. 5:15 to go, already leading at 21-0. Maryland eye, or power eye, if you want to call it that, two fullbacks and a running back deep. And it will be the deep running back, Becker, cuts back in as he was turned in, but turns it into a nice gain of about five. He's to the 41-yard line. Second down, a handful of yards to go as we cross the five-minute mark here in the ball game. At the 41, moving north to south, left to right. Cedar Catholic, no hurry to come out of the huddle here. They'll take their time before the snap. In fact, the quarterback, Caney, is looking at the back judge. When he puts his hand up and starts the sweeping motion, he knows there's 5 seconds, so he'll get under center. Caney will again give it to Becker. Becker again has to cut back in as the defender, Cole Fessler, on the right side has turned the play back in two times in a row. It'll be a gain to the 39-yard line, so third down, 3 yards for Cedar Catholic. They are 7 of 10 on third downs in this game. Came in at 50% on the season. Shotgun on third and three. Man in motion coming back across the formation. Now stops. Pivots back to the right. Tane trying to work outside. Taney's in trouble, and despite his elusiveness, will go down in the backfield. Technically a sack because he was back to pass, but it'll be at the 43-yard line. Loss of four on the play. Fourth down, 7 yards to go. So Bridgeport holding there apparently, but it will be a long time in the huddle here for Cedar Catholic with only 3:15 remaining. They'll use as much time as they can and then maybe call a timeout. We'll see. Yeah, they wait until the back judge starts swinging his arm in that 5-second count, and timeout is taken by Cedar Catholic. They milk the clock as much as they can. We'll hold it here with 2 minutes and 59 seconds to go. 14-0, Cedar Catholic on top. Again, earlier today, Mitchell losing at Wahoo. Tonight, Scott's Bluff will be at Aurora. That'll be on 106.9 The Trail for you with Chris Cottrell handling the play-by-play as always. Contact Jennifer Yurdialis, your local five-star lender with Castle & Cook Mortgage. For a simple, friendly, and fast loan process for your home purchase or refinance, contact Jennifer today. Castle & Cook Mortgage, the key to your castle. It'll be fourth down for Cedar Catholic. 2 minutes, 59 seconds to go. A rare punt for Noah Ahrens. Ball's at the 43-yard line of Bridgeport. Sole safety is Cole Fessler. Snap back's a good one. One-man rush, and the kick is away. High kick, and Fessler gathers it at the 10-yard line and is not going to make the 15 as Cedar Catholic, a lot of coverage men down there with 2:48 to go. The ball will be taken over for Bridgeport for what could be their final time this season, trailing 21 to nothing. It'll be at the 13-yard line. Cedar Catholic has kept Bridgeport from sniffing the end zone today. And, of course, Stoll went out as the injury when he was sacked and fumbled the ball on that last series. Yep, they'll have a new quarterback out there. That will be Jacob Wallison. Wallison up under center. Will play action, now gives it away, but again, hard running will not gain much for Cole Fessler as the Cedar Catholic defense in there to knock him down for no gain on the play. Well, he's going to pick up a yard the way it looks. So second down, 9 yards to go. Second and nine with 2:20 to go in the ball game. Wallison, a senior, 5'10", 150. He's 4 out of 10 passing, has a touchdown, 67 yards. He does try and put it in the air. Looks the defense over, bends over. Jalen Hayes gives him the snap. It's a pitch and a gain, nice gain this time of about 5 yards for Fessler. That'll make it third down and four from the 20-yard line. Minute and 47 to go. 8 first downs for Bridgeport in the ball game, 21 for Cedar Catholic. Cedar Catholic coming into the game with 355 yards total offense per game. Bridgeport was at 396, but Cedar Catholic's bottled them up well today. It'll be the first time Cedar Catholic has gotten a shutout in their last half of the season here. In fact, it'll be their first of the year, barring a long scoring play. Minute and 14 seconds on third down. Four to go. Wallison will pitch it. In trouble in the backfield, and Fessler will go down for a loss on the play. With a minute to go, kind of the defining statement for Cedar Catholic's defense. Loss of one brings up fourth down and five. Full sail subs coming in for Cedar Catholic. Fourth down, 5 yards to go, 35 seconds to go now as the clock continues to run. See if Bridgeport will take one final timeout here to avoid the penalty and allow them to make sure, yes, that's what they're allowed, and make sure they get a few more people in. Timeout, Bridgeport. 23 seconds to go, 21-0. Cedar Catholic on the West Coast scoreboard.
Many people count on space heaters and electric blankets to help stay warm in the winter. Here are a few safety tips. Space heaters need space all around them? Only buy space heaters that are tested and labeled by a national recognized facility. Before using a space heater or electric blanket, inspect the cord for cracks or warm spots. Finally, turn off electric blankets when not in use. Space heaters and electric blankets can provide needed comfort or can be deadly if not used with care. So use caution this winter season. This message is brought to you by Chimney Rock Public Power District, your Touchstone Energy partner, the power of human connections.
You may look forward to spending the seasons with family in your home, but not when these critters come knocking on your door. That's where Benzel Pest Control saves the day. Family-owned since 1976, we provide prompt, professional, and efficient services to keep your home or business safe and secure all year round.
With 3 generations and more than 4 decades of service to the Nebraska Panhandle in southeast Wyoming, Benzel Pest Control is the only name in all seasons pest defense.
The punt was a booming kick down to the 40, but Grant Ahrens had a couple of blockers in front of him and takes it back inside Bridgeport territory. And with 10 seconds to go, the ball will be spotted down at about the 41-yard line, the way it looks. So that was a 46-yard punt that time, but the return is 19 yards. The Bridgeport 41. Victory formation for Ty Taney. He'll take the snap, kneel down, and that's the final play of the ball game. So Hartington Cedar Catholic improves to 8-2 on the season. Bridgeport will finish at 6-2 as they had 2 games postponed or canceled due to the COVID-19. So their season ends, but a good one for Jeremy Reimers and the club nonetheless. Cedar Catholic, good team. Looked like they probably ended up with a couple of real tough teams at the end, or their record would have been even better. So no shame in losing to a good one, and Cedar Catholic ends up with the victory. So 21-0, runs of postgame shows coming up next. 21-0, Hartington Cedar Catholic on the West Coast scoreboard.
Changing leaf colors means yard work. Your friends at Tri-City Stormwater wants to remind you of the proper way to dispose of fallen leaves. Leaves make great mulch for trees and bushes and compost for future gardens. The city also has yard waste bins, so they can dispose of all your leaves at the city compost facility. Always keep your leaves out of the gutters. Not only do they cause clogging and flooding, they can pollute our waterways by causing nutrient overload. So keep your yard looking good and your drinking water safe, because it's our water, our responsibility.
Fly United Airlines, operated by SkyWest, with Western Nebraska Regional Airport. United is dedicated to going the extra mile for you with daily flights to and from Denver, along with a commitment to excellent service. Reserve your flight today, and remember, United miles can be earned and redeemed with your flights. While at the airport, stop and enjoy authentic Italian food at Roma Italian Restaurant. Plus, Hertz Thrifty Car Rental is there for your car rental needs. Make life easier, relax, and get on board with Western Nebraska Regional Airport.
Well, thank you, and welcome back if you're a Bridgeport fan, of course. Not the outcome you were hoping for, but both teams got together in the center of the field afterward. Good gestures of sportsmanship by both squads, and it ends up 21-0 Cedar Catholic. Scoreless first quarter, scoreless third quarter. But in the second quarter of play, Cedar Catholic got on the board. Miles Taney, a 21-yard run, kicked good by Ahrens, and the 10-play, 75-yard drive capped off, making it 7-0. Time elapsed was 4 minutes, 12 seconds. Exactly 3 minutes later, Easton Becker scores from 3 yards out. That was a 7-play, 61-yard drive that took only a minute and 44 seconds off the clock. 14-0 after the Ahrens kick. As I said, a scoreless third quarter, so 14-0 entering the fourth quarter. And Becker scores from 4 yards out on the first play of the fourth, 11:49 to go. And the kick makes it 21-0 as Ahrens was perfect on all three of his attempts today. 7-play, only 43-yard drive as they set up in Bridgeport territory, and exactly 2 minutes off the clock for Cedar Catholic. And we could have stopped right then as that finalized everything for us in the ball game. We'll look at some of the team stats when we come back here on the Runs of Post Game Show. Again, 21-0 Cedar Catholic on the West Coast scoreboard.
Coverage of today's game on KNEB.TV is brought to you by Chimney Rock Chiropractic. Nine Pharmacy and Gifts. Farmers State Bank. And by Corman Seed Company.
When you call Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating, you will have options. Repair it, rebuild it, or update it. Whether your furnace stops working or your bathtub won't drain, Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating provides the services you need to be comfortable. Weekends, holidays, or late nights, we will be there. With over 30 years of service, our certified technicians and cutting-edge technology can keep your systems running at their peak efficiency. Gearing Valley Plumbing and Heating, every time we enter your home, we leave it a better place to live.
Well, with Hartington Cedar Catholic winning the ball game today, they could host next week, depending on Oakland, Craig, or Crofton in the other game going on later on today. But Crofton, the 14 seed, so Hartington should get the game at home regardless. So home game next Friday for Hartington Cedar Catholic. Some of the stats at halftime, 4 penalties, 50 yards on Cedar Catholic, only 1 5-yarder in the second half, so 5 for 55 total. Don't have one down for Bridgeport in this game. Turnovers, that one late by Stoll when he was hit as he was ready to throw, the only turnover for Bridgeport in the ball game. And for Cedar Catholic, their quarterback, Tate Taney, was hit as he threw on the first drive of the game way back in the first quarter, and the ball was intercepted. So that turnover, and then they had a fumble on a trying to get it to the fullback on a trap play and just never made connections, and that one was recovered by Bridgeport. So 2 turnovers in the ball game against Cedar Catholic, but they come out with the victory 21-0. In third down conversions, Bridgeport 2 of 9, and 7 out of 11 for Cedar Catholic. Cedar Catholic went for it 3 times on fourth down and made it 2. So their percentages, as they have proved out through the regular season, pretty good on those third and fourth downs. We still have the player of the game to bring you, so we'll be back with that to wrap up the Runza postgame show after this. Welcome back. This one 21-0, Cedar Catholic over Bridgeport. Earlier, Mitchell traveled to Wahoo and lost 34-14. Scott's Bluff will be on the trail, 106.9 tonight at 6 Mountain Time. Chris Cottrell will have the pregame from Aurora, as Scott's Bluff, 12th seed, and Aurora, the 5th seed. And they've already met once this year, Aurora winning at Aurora, coincidentally enough, in that one also. So that's coming up. Well, Player of the Game is brought to you by Taco John's of Scott's Bluff and Gehring. Make Taco John's a game day tradition by unwrapping the original before or after the game. And tonight, or this afternoon yet, as it's still the sun up, Easton Becker, the junior running back for Hartington Cedar Catholic, named as our Player of the Game. You could probably put their defense as a whole, as they bottled up Bridgeport, one of the better defenses that I'd say Bridgeport has seen this year. St. Pat's had beaten them 17-14 in their only regular season loss. So that's going to take care of it from Bridgeport. Thanks for being along today. Chuck Swartz wishing you a good afternoon and reminding you again, the final was Hartington Cedar Catholic 21, Bridgeport nothing.
Cause I got the best seat. Just when I thought it couldn't get any hotter, you slid on.